ourselves to this ministry of prayer, whether we're more comfortable using the prayer book resources, lots of ready-made prayers there, or whether we feel okay spontaneously putting words to how we feel in the moment with God, stewarding our prayers in community is essential to this life of faith. Our prayerful patterns in church certainly have a lot of moving parts. You know, we process, we do these things, we come and receive communion, and they are meant to be powerful, symbolic, but they're also meant to allow us to encounter one another, because Christ's body what you are, become what you receive, the body and blood of Christ. That was Augustine's classic formulation, lifting up the Eucharist. His words witness to the power of our communal prayers, prayers that knit us back together as one, body and soul. Now, I realize that we haven't shared in the common cup in several years because we've been caring for one another's well-being during the pandemic. And while we clearly aren't out of the viral woods, I pray that we will discern with our leadership when communion wine can be reintroduced at St. Paul's, especially now that the bishop has begun to make some provisions for churches in our diocese to think about bringing back the cup with certain safety constraints. Re-engaging this muscle memory is a faithful way to steward the powerful ancient prayers that have been entrusted to us in our tradition, prayers that have knit Christians together for centuries. This, too, is part of our healing path forward, because we are meant to know ourselves connected in one body, flesh and blood signs of God's risen life. These foundational prayers transform us every time we gather in Christ's name. So let us steward this life that is entrusted to us with courage and hope, leaning into the joy of